Good morning students. First of all, welcome to the AP Residential Schools. Today we are going to start first chapter from 8th class, that is rational numbers. Okay, before going to discuss about the rational numbers, we have to recollect. So, before going to discuss about this chapter, we have to recollect what are the numbers we know before in the earlier classes. Let us see. So, in 6th class and 7th class, which type of numbers we learnt about? We learnt about the natural numbers, whole numbers and integers. So, let us see what are natural numbers. Natural numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. The numbers which are useful in our daily life and the numbers which are useful for counting, those numbers are called as the natural numbers. And the smallest natural number is 1, greatest natural number is cannot be defined. And the set of natural numbers are denoted with the capital N. If we are included 0 to these natural numbers, then what it will be? The natural numbers along with 0 are called as whole numbers. So the set of whole numbers are denoted with capital W. Once I observe these two natural numbers and whole numbers, in these whole numbers except 0, remaining all numbers are natural numbers. Now can we say that all the natural numbers are whole numbers? Yes, it is correct, because all the natural numbers are belongs to the set whole number set. Okay, except 0. 0 is only the extra element in the whole number set. Okay, now and another number system we learnt in the 7th class is integer set. What are integers? All the positive numbers, 0 and all the negative numbers. The set which containing all the positive numbers, all the negative numbers and also 0. This set is called as the integer set. And the set of integers are denoted with capital I, or it is denoted with capital Z. Why we are representing the integer set with Z? Yeah, Z means it is coming from the German word Zeppelin. Zeppelin means numbers. So, the first letter of the Zeppelin, with this letter we are representing the set of integers. Okay, ma? So, now once observe the integer set. In this integer set, we are having all the natural numbers. And we are having the all the whole numbers also. With the natural numbers and whole numbers, extra we are having the negative numbers in the integers set. Okay. Now, see one example. So, in your class, one boy is there. His name is Raju. Raju bought 5 pence. Okay. And he bought that 5 pence for the cost of 22 rupees. See this one. Cost of 5 pence is equal to 22 rupees. Then what is the cost of 1 pen? Cost of 1 pen is equal to 22 by 5. Is it correct or not? Now, see, once observe this number. Is there this type of numbers in the natural numbers or in the whole numbers or in the integers? Okay. Ekkadaina chusara meeru ee mooditlo? Leduga? Ante manaku telisina natural numbers, whole numbers, integers maatrame kaakunda inkoka number system kuda undi. ఆ నెంబర్ సిస్టంలో ఉండే నంబర్స్ ఇలా సమ్ P by Q अने form लो उन्टाई. Okay ना? इलांटी numbers ने rational numbers अंटामू. So, मनों ये रोज नेच्चको बोये chapter rational numbers. Okay मा? So, let us see the definition of the rational numbers. The numbers which can be written in the form of P by Q, where P, Q are integers and Q must be not equal to 0 are called rational numbers. Once again, see the definition. The numbers which can be written in the form of P by Q, where P, Q are any two integers and Q must be not equal to 0. Yenduku Q not equal to 0 and tisko wali? For example, ippudu meer ganaka, suppose, oka number tiskundam. 3 by 0 ane form lo oka number tiskunte nenu. Okay? Din meaning enti 3 ni 0 to divide chestunnanu ani ardham. Avuna? 0 तो divide चेसे डपडु, नुँ ये number नी multiply चेसना, answer 0 आउथुंदु गानी, इदी division आवडानिक अवकास में होना उन्टुंद, that means here it, the division is not possible, अवना, काबट्टी 0 तो divide चेसना अपडु, division अने दी possible कादु काबट्टी, वक number, rational number अव्वाली अंटे, the denominator, that must be not equal to 0 అవ్వాలి. ఓకేనా? అర్థమైందా ఎందుకు q not equal to 0 అని తీసుకుంటున్నామో అర్థమవుతుందిగా. ఓకే, నౌ సో దిస్ రేషనల్ నంబర్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ద కోషెంట్ నంబర్స్. రేషనల్ నంబర్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ద కోషెంట్ నంబర్స్. ఎందుకు కోషెంట్ నంబర్స్ అంటున్నాము అంటే, ఇప్పుడే చూసాం కదా మనం ఒక నెంబర్ని తీసుకున్నా నేను 32/4 అనే ఒక నెంబర్ ని తీసుకున్నాను. ఓకేనా? ఈ 32/4 లో ఈ 32 అనేది ఒక ఇంటిజర్, 4 అనేది ఒక ఇంటిజర్. ఈ నెంబర్ p / q ఫామ్ లో ఉంది కదా. అంటే దీని మీనింగ్ ఏంటి? 32 ని మనం 4 తో డివైడ్ చేస్తున్నాము అని అర్థం. అవునా? 4 తో డివైడ్ చేసినప్పుడు ఇక్కడ వచ్చే ఆన్సర్ ఏంటి? 4 8s are 32. సో ద రిజల్ట్, ద ఆన్సర్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ నెంబర్ ఇస్ 8, which is nothing but the quotient. దీని quotient అనేగా అనేది మనం. కాబట్టి rational numbers are also nothing but the quotient numbers. With the first letter of this quotient numbers, so the rational numbers are represented with capital Q. Okay, understand? The rational numbers are represented with the capital Q because the result of the rational number is a కోషెంట్. కాబట్టి మనం వాటిని కోషెంట్ నంబర్స్ అని కూడా అంటాం. ఇప్పుడు ఒక ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చూద్దాం. టేక్ సమ్ మోర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ ఆఫ్ ద రేషనల్ నంబర్స్. ఓకే, -5/7 ఇది ఒక రేషనల్ నంబర్ అవుతుందా అవదా? Let us check. Is this number in the form of P by Q? P by Q form lo unda leda? Yes, it is in the form of P by Q. And -5 is an integer or not? Yes, -5 is integer. Here this symbol is called as belongs to. What is the meaning? Belongs to means ఇది ఆ సెట్లో ఉన్న నంబర్, ఆ సెట్కి చెందినటువంటి నెంబర్ అని చూపించడానికి బిలాంగ్స్ టు అనే సింబల్ని వాడతాము. ఇక్కడ మైనస్ ఫైవ్ అనేది ఒక ఇంటీజర్ అవుతుంది, అలాగే సెవెన్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో అన్ ఇంటీజర్. మన డెఫినేషన్ ఏంటి, రేషనల్ నెంబర్ డెఫినేషన్ ఏంటి? ద నెంబర్స్ విచ్ క్యాన్ బి రిటన్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ పీ బై క్యూ. ఈ నెంబర్ పీ బై క్యూ ఫామ్లో ఉంది. అండ్ వేర్ పీ కామా క్యూ ఆర్ ఇంటీజర్స్. ఇక్కడ మైనస్ ఫైవ్ ఒక ఇంటీజర్, సెవెన్ ఒక ఇంటీజర్. అండ్ క్యూ మస్ట్ బి నాట్ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో. సెవెన్ అనేది నాట్ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో కదా. ఇప్పుడు మన డెఫినేషన్లో ఉన్న అన్ని కండిషన్స్ ఈ నెంబర్ సాటిస్ఫై చేసిందా లేదా? కాబట్టి ఈ నెంబర్ని మనం రేషనల్ నెంబర్ అని అనొచ్చా? ఎస్, మైనస్ ఫైవ్ బై సెవెన్ ఈజ్ ఏ రేషనల్ నెంబర్. ఓకేనా? నౌ లెట్ అస్ టేక్ వన్ మోర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్. ఐఎమ్ టేకింగ్ ద నెంబర్ నైన్. ఈజ్ నైన్ ఈజ్ ఏ రేషనల్ నెంబర్ ఆర్ నాట్? లెట్ అస్ సీ. మరి మనకి రేషనల్ నెంబర్ డెఫినేషన్ ప్రకారం నెంబర్స్ అనేవి పీ బై క్యూ ఫామ్లో ఉండాలని చెప్పుకున్నాం కదా. మరి నైన్ పీ బై క్యూ ఫామ్లో రాయొచ్చా లేదా మనం? ఎస్, వీ కెన్ రైట్. సీ దిస్ వన్, 9 can be written as 9 by 1, or 9 can be written as 18 by 2, or 9 can be written as 90 by 10, and so on. ఎలా అయినా రాయచ్చు 9. ఈ నెంబర్ ఇప్పుడు పీ బై క్యూ ఫామ్లో ఉందా లేదా? ఎస్. అలాగే ప్రతి నెంబర్ ఇంటీజర్ సెట్లో ఉన్నాయా లేవా? 9 బిలాంగ్స్ టు ఇంటీజర్ సెట్ అండ్ 1 ఈజ్ ఆల్సో అన్ ఇంటీజర్ అండ్ 1 మస్ట్ బి నాట్ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో. ఇజ్ ఇట్ కరెక్ట్ ఆర్ నాట్? ఎస్, ఇట్ ఈస్ సాటిస్ఫైయింగ్ ద కండిషన్ ఆఫ్ ద డెఫినేషన్ ఆఫ్ ద రేషనల్ నెంబర్స్. అంటే ఇప్పుడు దీన్ని బట్టి మనం ఏం అర్థం చేసుకోవచ్చు? ఏ న్యాచురల్ నంబర్ నైన్ ఒకటే కాదు, అది వన్ అవ్వచ్చు, టూ అవ్వచ్చు, త్రీ అవ్వచ్చు, ఏ నెంబర్ అయినా అవ్వచ్చు. మీరు న్యాచురల్ నంబర్ సెట్లో ఏ నెంబర్ని తీసుకున్నా కూడా అది ఖచ్చితంగా రేషనల్ నంబర్ అవుతుంది. నౌ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ we can say that every natural number is a rational number. So all the natural numbers are belongs to the rational numbers. Is it correct or not? Now let us see for the whole numbers. See this one. So let us take the number 0. Now, can you say that 0 is a rational number or not? Let us see. So 0 can be written as 0 by 1 or 0 by 2 and so on. 0ని మనం 0 by 1గా రాసుకోవచ్చు, 0 by 2 రాయొచ్చు, 0 by 100 రాయొచ్చు, ఎలా అయినా రాయొచ్చు. 0 అనేది ఇంటీజర్ సెట్లో ఉందా లేదా? ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ పీ బై క్యూ అండ్ 0 ఈజ్ అన్ ఇంటీజర్, క్యూ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో అన్ ఇంటీజర్ అండ్ హియర్ దట్ ఈజ్ 1 ఈజ్ ఆల్సో అన్ ఇంటీజర్ అండ్ 1 మస్ట్ బి నాట్ ఈక్వల్ టు 0. ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో సాటిస్ఫైయింగ్ ద కండిషన్ ఆఫ్ ద రేషనల్ numbers. So we can say that 0 is also a rational number. That means all the whole numbers are also rational numbers. So from this we can say that all whole numbers are belongs to rational numbers. So we can represent it is W is belongs to Q. అంటే ఇప్పటి వరకు మనకి ఏం అర్థమైంది చూడండి, న్యాచురల్ నంబర్స్ అన్నీ కూడా రేషనల్ నంబర్స్ అవుతాయని, అలాగే హోల్ నంబర్స్ అన్నీ కూడా రేషనల్ నంబర్స్ అవుతాయని అర్థమైంది. ఓకేనా? ఇప్పుడు ఇంటీజర్స్ చూద్దాం. ఇంటీజర్స్ అంటే ఏంటి? ఆల్రెడీ మనం డిస్కస్ చేసాం కదా, న్యాచురల్ నంబర్స్ హోల్ నంబర్స్తో పాటుగా నెగిటివ్ నెంబర్స్ని కూడా కలిపి ఉంటుంది. Now let us check for the integers. Okay, now I am taking one of the integer minus 7. Integer means not only the negative number, any positive number or any negative number or zero. We can take any of the number as a integer. ఇక్కడ నేను ఒక నెగిటివ్ నెంబర్ని తీసుకున్నాను. దిస్ నెగిటివ్ నెంబర్ ఆల్సో వీ కెన్ రైట్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ పి బై క్యూ అండ్ హియర్ ఆల్సో అండ్ వన్ మస్ట్ బి నాట్ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో. సో దట్ మీన్స్ వీ కెన్ సే దట్ ఆల్ ద ఇంటీజర్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో బిలాంగ్స్ టు ద రేషనల్ నెంబర్స్ సెట్. దట్ మీన్స్ వీ కెన్ సే దట్ ఆల్ ద ఇంటీజర్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో రేషనల్ నెంబర్స్. సో ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ వీ కెన్ కన్క్లూడ్ దట్ natural numbers or belongs to the whole number set and all whole numbers are belongs to the integer set and all integers are belongs to the rational numbers but the vice versa is not true. Anni rational numbers integers avavu, anni rational numbers whole numbers avavu, anni rational numbers natural numbers avavu, but all natural numbers are rational numbers. All whole numbers are also rational numbers and all the integers are also rational numbers. Okay, now these rational numbers are having some of the properties. Let us see what are those properties. Yes, properties of rational numbers. The first property is closure property. This closure property is we have to apply for all the four binary operations, those are addition, subtraction, multiplication and also division. Let us see the closure property is existing for the rational numbers under, first of all we are going to check for the addition. Take any two rational numbers. I am taking the numbers 1/2, 3/5. I am taking two rational numbers. Add those two numbers, 1/2 + 3/5. So the LCM is 2 5s are 10 and 5 1s are 5 + 3 2s 6. If there is no common factor, LCM is the product kada. Okay, now the number is 11/10. Is it there in the form of P by Q? Is it a rational number? Yes, it is also a rational number. That means the sum of any two rational numbers is also a rational number. That is, for all A comma B belongs to Q. This symbol is called as for all. For all means ప్రతి ఒక్క రేషనల్ నంబరు అని మీనింగ్ అన్నమాట ఇక్కడ. ఓకేనా? ఫర్ ఆల్ ఏ కామా బి బిలాంగ్స్ టు క్యూ. ఓకే, ఏ ప్లస్ బి ద సమ్ ఆఫ్ టూ రేషనల్ నంబర్స్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో ఏ రేషనల్ నంబర్. ఏ ప్లస్ బి ఈజ్ ఆల్సో బిలాంగ్స్ టు క్యూ. ఓకే, దిస్ ప్రాపర్టీ ఆఫ్ ద రేషనల్ నంబర్స్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ద క్లోజర్ ప్రాపర్టీ. ఓకే, దట్ మీన్స్ రేషనల్ నంబర్స్ ఆర్ క్లోజ్డ్ under addition. అంటే under addition the rational numbers are satisfying the property of closure property. Okay, now second one under subtraction. Here also, let us take any of the two rational numbers. If A comma B or belongs to any two rational numbers, okay, then a minus b is also belongs to a rational number. Let us see. Take one example. Same example I am taking 1 by 2 and 3 by 5. Yeah. The difference of these two rational numbers I am taking. Here also once again the LCM is 10. And this is 5 ones are 5. Minus 6. 5 minus 6 means minus 1 by 10. Now is it a rational number or not? Yes, minus 1 by 10 is also in the form of P by Q. It is also a rational number. So that means the difference of any two rational numbers is also a rational number. And also the rational numbers are closed under subtraction. Under subtraction. Ante rational numbers under addition, under subtraction. With this both the properties it is satisfying. Under addition and under subtraction. And go for the next binary operation, that is multiplication. See this one. Once again I am taking two rational numbers a comma b and av. For all a comma b is belongs to rational numbers, then the product a into b is also a rational number. For example, 1 by 2 into 3 by 5, that number only. So I am doing the product. 1 3s are 3, 2 5s are 10. This is also in the form of P by Q. This is also a rational number. That means we can conclude from here, the product of any two rational numbers is also a rational number. So that means the rational numbers are satisfying the closure property under multiplication. That means here, so rational numbers are closed under multiplication. Now this is under multiplication. Third property, third one, and the fourth one is under division. See this one. ఈ టూ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ మళ్ళీ తీసుకుంటున్నాను. 1/2 కామా 3/5 అనేవి టూ రేషనల్ నంబర్స్ అయితే దేర్ డివిజన్ ఆల్సో, దట్ మీన్స్ 1/2 డివైడెడ్ బై 3/5. లెట్ అస్ సీ ద ఆన్సర్. ఫ్రాక్షన్ డివిజన్ ఇన్ ఫ్రాక్షన్స్ మీన్స్ దిస్ విల్ బి రెసిప్రోకల్. ఎస్, దెన్ ఇట్ ఈజ్ 1 5s are 5, 2 3s are 6. నౌ ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ P by Q. Is it correct or not? Yes, it is also a rational number. So from this we can conclude that the division of any two rational numbers is also a rational number. That means here if a comma b, for all a comma b belongs to Q, then a divided by b is also a rational number. That means these rational numbers are closed under division also. So this closure property is satisfying for all the four binary operations in the rational numbers. That means rational numbers are closed under addition, under subtraction, under multiplication, and also under division. Now let us come to the second property, that is commutative property. Here also we are going to check the commutative property of rational numbers under the four binary operations. So first of all we are going to check for the addition. Let us take any two rational numbers here. I am taking two rational numbers, that is 1 by 2 and 3 by 5. I am doing addition for them.
After that, I am doing the addition by changing the order. Then also I am getting the same answer. That means the value of addition cannot be changed by changing the order also. That means here A plus B is same as B plus A. So here the commutative property satisfies under addition for the rational numbers. Okay. Now let us check. It is satisfying the for the subtraction also. Chudam. So here also I am taking the same rational numbers. I am doing the subtraction. I am subtracting 3 by 5 from 1 by 2. I got the answer minus 1 by 10. But when I change the order 3 by 5, here I am subtracting 1 by 2 from 3 by 5. Then I got the answer plus 1 by 10. But these two values are not equal. That means here the commutative property is not satisfying under subtraction for the rational numbers. Rational numbers are not commutative under subtraction. So this is about the addition and subtraction. Now let us check for the multiplication. So I am taking two rational numbers 1 by 2 comma 3 by 5. So do the product 1 by 2 into 3 by 5. 1 3 is 3. We have to multiply the numerator with the numerator, denominator with the denominator. Now do the same product by changing the order. Then also I am getting the answer 3 by 10. That means here if we change the order, But the product remains same. So if A comma B, for all A comma B belongs to Q, A into B is equal to B into A. That means the set of rational numbers are satisfying the commutative property under multiplication. So the rational numbers are commutative under multiplication. Therefore, rational numbers are commutative under multiplication. Let us check for the division. So I am doing 1 by 2 divided by 3 by 5. That is, while doing the division of these rational numbers, so the division will become multiplication, and we have to take the reciprocal of the second one. So then it will be 1 5 is 5 and 2 3 is 6. Now I am changing the order 3 by 5 divided by 1 by 2. That is 3 by 5 into 2 by 1. So we got the answer 6 by 5. But here 5 by 6 is not equal to 6 by 5. So this concludes that rational numbers are not satisfying the commutative property under division. Therefore, rational numbers are not commutative under division. So this commutative property satisfies only under addition, under subtraction. Sorry, under multiplication. But it is not satisfying the commutative property under subtraction and under division. Okay. Now let us go for the third property, that is associative property. Associative property also we are going to check for all four binary operations. That is, the third property is associative property under addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So if you are taken for all, here we have to take any three rational numbers. Okay. So first of all, under addition, here A plus B plus C is same as A plus B plus C. That means when we are taking any of the three rational numbers, if you are doing the addition of them, the sum must be same when we are changing the order. If you change the order, but the sum must be same, then we can say that the associative property will be satisfied under the rational numbers. Let us take any three rational numbers. Here I am taking 2, 3 and 5. So already we proved that all the natural numbers and all the whole numbers and all the integers are also rational numbers. So I am taking, for easy calculation, I am taking here 3 rational numbers, 2, 3 and 5. I am doing the addition. Here I am changing the order and also I am doing the addition. See this one. 2 plus 3 plus 5 value is 8. Here 2 plus 3 value is 5. Now I am having left hand side I am having 10 and right hand side also we are getting same. Here LHS is same as RHS. Both the values are same. That means if you change the order also, the sum remains the same. So this proves that the set of rational numbers are satisfying the associative property under addition. Okay. Now let us go for the subtraction. Here we have to prove A minus B minus C is same as A minus B minus C. Take the same numbers 2 minus 3 minus 5 is equal to 2 minus 3 minus 5. So 3 minus 5 value is minus 2. 2 minus 3 value is minus 1. So here minus of minus will be plus. 2 plus 2 is equal to minus 1 minus 1. Here 4 is equal to minus 6. Is it equal both of? Here we are left hand side we are getting the plus 4 and right hand side we get the minus 6. Both are not equal. So we can say that A minus B minus C is not equal to A minus B minus C. So this proves that the set of rational numbers are not satisfying the associative property under subtraction. It is not satisfying the associative property under subtraction. Now let us check for the multiplication. So here associative property under multiplication. If A, B, C are any three real numbers, here also I am taking 2, 3 and 5. 2 into 3 into 5 is same as 2 into 3 into 5. Here also I want to prove that LHS is equal to RHS. That is A into B into C is same as A into B into C. Now let us see. 2 into 3 5s are 15. And here 2 3s are 6 into 5. So we got 2 15s are 30. Here 6 5s are 30. So here I got both LHS and RHS are same. Okay. So now from this we can conclude that the set of rational numbers are satisfying the associative property under multiplication. Okay. Now let us go for the division. Here I have 2 divided by 3 divided by 5 is equal to 2 divided by 3 divided by 5. 2 divided by 3 by 5 is equal to 2 by 3 divided by 5. Here nothing is there means 1. So we cannot do the division of the rational numbers directly. We have to convert into multiplication, and we have to take the reciprocal of the second one. So this is 2 by 3 into 1 by 5. 2 5s are 10 by 3. Here 2 1s are 2 by 15. But both the values are not equal here. So this example is concluded that here A divided by B divided by C is not equal to A divided by B divided by C. That means the set of rational numbers are not satisfying the associative property under division. So this is about the associative property. Once again check, associative property is satisfying for the rational numbers only under addition and under multiplication, but it is not satisfying under subtraction and under division. Okay, and one more is there, that is so what is the role of zero here? See this one. I am taking one of the rational number, that is 1 by 5. I am adding 0. Then what is the result? Its value is once again 1 by 5. I am adding 1 by 5 to 0. Then also I got the same answer. That means while adding 0 to the any of the rational number, the result is same, but there is no change in the value. So we can say that 0 is acting as an additive identity in the rational number system. That means, so we can say that additive identity means while adding this number, there is no change in the value. So we can say that 0 is the additive identity for the set of rational numbers. Now, in the same way, with which number when we multiply this number, the result will be the same. A number to multiply chesinappudu result same avutundi. A number teeskovali. See this one. Here we have to multiply. Suppose if I am taking 0, its value will become 0. But to get the same answer, here we have to multiply with 1. Is it correct or not? Yes. So 1 into 1 by 5 also, its value remains the same. So while multiplying with 1, there is no change in the value. So here 1 is acting as a multiplicative identity for the rational numbers. So here, multiplicative identity is one for rational numbers. So here 0 is the additive identity for the rational numbers, and 1 is the multiplicative identity for the rational numbers. And there is one more property, that is the existence of inverse. First of all, additive inverse. నేను a అనే ఒక రేషనల్ నంబర్ ని తీసుకున్నాను. దానికి వేరే ఇంకా ఏ రేషనల్ నంబర్ ని యాడ్ చేస్తే నాకు ఆన్సర్ 0 వస్తుంది. a అనే నంబర్ కి ఏ నంబర్ ని యాడ్ చేస్తే ఆన్సర్ 0 వస్తుంది. థింక్ వన్స్, a అనే నంబర్ కి ఏ నంబర్ ని యాడ్ చేస్తే ఆన్సర్ 0 వస్తుంది? Yes, that is minus a. In the same way, 6 and a number ki a number ne add cheste answer 0 avutundi. That is minus 6. Okay. So, in these rational numbers, if the sum of any two rational numbers is equal to 0, then those two numbers are additive inverse to each other. That means here minus a is the additive inverse of a and a is the additive inverse of minus a. Now let us come to the multiplicative inverse. ఇక్కడ ఎడిటివ్ ఇన్వర్స్ లో ఏ రెండు నంబర్స్ ని యాడ్ చేస్తే ఆన్సర్ జీరో వచ్చిందో ఆ రెండు నంబర్స్ ఎడిటివ్ ఇన్వర్స్ అయినాయి. ఇప్పుడు మల్టిప్లికేటివ్ ఇన్వర్స్ వచ్చేసరికి మనం ఒక నంబర్ ని తీసుకున్నప్పుడు ఆ నంబర్ ని ఏ నంబర్ తో మల్టిప్లై చేస్తే ఆన్సర్ 1 వస్తుంది. జాగ్రత్తగా చూడండి, ఒక నంబర్ ఒక రేషనల్ నంబర్ ని తీసుకున్నప్పుడు అది ఏ నంబర్ తో మల్టిప్లై చేస్తే ఆన్సర్ 1 వస్తుందో చూడాలి. ఇప్పుడు 1/5 అనే నంబర్ ని నేను 5 తో మల్టిప్లై చేస్తే 5 క్యాన్సిల్ అయిపోయి ఆన్సర్ 1 అవుతుందా లేదా? అట్లాగే 5 అనే నంబర్ ని 1/5 అనే నంబర్ తో మల్టిప్లై చేస్తే 5 క్యాన్సిల్ అయిపోయి ఇప్పుడు కూడా ఆన్సర్ 1 అవుతుంది కదా. దట్ మీన్స్ ఇఫ్ ద ప్రొడక్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎనీ టు నంబర్స్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 1 దెన్ దోస్ టు నంబర్స్ ఆర్ యాక్టింగ్ యాస్ ద మల్టిప్లికేటివ్ ఇన్వర్స్ టు ఈచ్ అదర్. దట్ ఈస్ ఇఫ్ ద product of any two rational numbers is equal to 1, then those two numbers are multiplicative inverse to each other. So if a is one of the rational number, there exists another rational number 1/a whose product is equal to 1. So here a and 1/a are the multiplicative inverse to each other. And the next, last but not least, one more property is there for the rational numbers, that is distributive property. Distribution of multiplication over addition. See this one. That means if you are taking any of the, for all a comma b comma c belongs to rational numbers. ఏబిసిలు ఏవైనా మూడు రేషనల్ నంబర్స్ అయితే ఓకే. దట్ మీన్స్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ హియర్ ఐఎమ్ టేకింగ్ 2, 3, 5 దెన్ హియర్ ఏ ఇంటూ బి ప్లస్ సి ఈజ్ సేమ్ యాజ్ ఏబి ప్లస్ బిసి. దిస్ ఈస్ ద డిస్ట్రిబ్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ మల్టిప్లికేషన్ ఓవర్ ఎడిషన్. అంటే ముందు బి ప్లస్ సిని యాడ్ చేసి తర్వాత ఏతో మల్టిప్లై చేసినా, లేదా ముందు ఏని బి ఏని బితో ఏని సితో మల్టిప్లై చేసి ఆ రెండింటికి సమ్ చేసినా సేమ్ ఆన్సర్ వస్తుంది అనేది దీని మీనింగ్ అన్నమాట. లెట్ అస్ సీ. 2 × 3 + 5 ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 2 × 3 plus 2 into 5. That is equal to 2 into 3 plus 5 is 8. 2 3s are 6, 2 5s are 10, which is equal to 16. So I got both LHs and RHs are same. Okay, this is the distribution of multiplication over addition. So this satisfies that the distribution property, distributive property satisfies for the set of rational numbers. Therefore, set of the rational numbers are satisfies distributive property. So these are all about the rational numbers. Okay, once recollect what we have learned today. Okay, so first of all we learned the definition of the rational numbers. After that we learned about the properties of the rational numbers. Which properties we learned? We learned about the closure property, tarvata commutative property, next associative property, next identity, additive identity, multiplicative identity, additive inverse and multiplicative inverse. And next we learned about the distributive property. Yes, once recollect, the distributive one, that is the closure property satisfies for the all the four binary operations, for addition, for subtraction, for multiplication and also for division. And commutative property satisfies only for the addition and multiplication, but not satisfies the subtraction and division. In the same way, associative property also satisfies only for the addition and subtraction, but not for the associative property satisfies only for the addition and multiplication, but not for the subtraction and division. Okay. And what is the additive identity in the rational number system? Yes, 0 is the additive identity for the rational number system. And what is the multiplicative identity? 1 is the multiplicative identity. So, what is the additive inverse? Additive inverse means when we add any two numbers, if you got the result is equal to 0, then those two numbers are called as the additive inverse to each other. And what is the multiplicative inverse?
Correct.
If the product of any two numbers is equal to 1, then those two numbers are acting as the multiplicative inverse to each other. Okay, now after that we learned about this distributive property. So if A into B plus C is equal to AB plus AC, then we can say that the distributive property will be satisfied for the rational numbers. So that's it for today. Thank you.